Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Carolina Ketchup. Our top stories tonight: why the CIA won't tell you about the snakes holding firearms, 10 buildings in Denver, Colorado that are definitely connected to the Illuminati, and finally, where's my dad and why is it taking him so long to get cigarettes? But first, here at Carolina Ketchup, Pope Francis has announced that he's extending his visit to the U.S. by adding the Big Apple to the list, presumably to make his yearly pilgrimage to Sbarro's. While he's here, the Pope is expected to make an announcement that all the hipsters in Williamsburg are welcome in heaven, or he'll just go to an artisanal homemade pickle shop or something else really chill that all of your Catholic friends will definitely tell you about a bunch of times. Secretary of State John Kerry addressed the Charlie Hebdo killings with an act appropriate of such a tragedy by sending foreign diplomat and rock and roll Hall of Famer James Taylor. Kerry wanted to share a hug with the French people by forcing a crowd of victims, survivors, and family members to listen to the song You've Got a Friend, featuring the lyrics like, "Close your eyes, France, and think of me, your loving friend of the United States, and soon I'll be there to brighten up even your darkest nights." Maybe Kerry missed the North Carolina native's message of friendship when deciding whether to send a rep to France's Unity March. Yet with this keen understanding of U.S. foreign relations, Kerry certainly knows how to fill the families of the victims with hope. Maybe next time he'll give Randy Newman a ring. German model Benshin claims the top spot for the world's largest fake breasts. The size 32Z breasts weigh in at a modest 20 pounds each, further confirming the international acknowledgement that Germany is the America of Europe. In the inaugural Oh Florida segment, a resident reptile shop owner is facing battery and charges of animal cruelty after striking an employee with a bearded lizard dragon, suggesting that things such as laws and due process somehow do exist in this paradoxical state of fanboats and alligator hats. This is also the establishment that made headlines in 2012 after a man died from consuming a bunch of insects in the store-sponsored roach-eating contest. The State of the Union, or what I like to call Obama swinging his dick around 2015 edition, was called this past week. The chief of state's raging semi can be attributed to the lowest unemployment rates since the 90s, Putin's falling Russian economy, and the news that Mitt Romney might run in 2016. Now for our biggest story tonight. 2015 marks the 50th anniversary of the voting rights marches led by Martin Luther King Jr., which happens to fall in line with the recently released film, Selma. The critically acclaimed film has been nominated by the Academy for Best Picture and Original Song, yet it wasn't nominated in any other categories. Specifically Best Actor for Ava DuVernay and Best Leading Actor for David Oyelowo. These two snubs, as well as the fact that this is the whitest Oscar pool since 1998, has caused people to question the Academy's members. A diverse pool of people, including the fact that they're 93% Caucasian, 76% male, and have the average age of 63 years old. Some Academy members claim that they've clearly proven how unracist they are in overlooking the film because they gave last year's Best Picture to 12 Years a Slave. Quote, "It's almost like because she's African-American, we should have made her one of the nominees," says one Academy member. "I think that's racist. Look at what we did last year with 12 Years. "Right, because when it comes to giving out subjective awards, we should consider who won last time so no one gets unfair treatment." Plus, the issues that the movie addresses are no longer relevant to the current American political climate. Look, the Justice Department analyzed the Ferguson decision and they found that there were no civil rights issues involved with Darren Wilson's indictment. Clearly, racism is dead in America, and I say it's about time. I mean, finally, we can all calm down. People say we couldn't end racism, but the rich white men who are the policymakers of our society, they say it's over. Let's not forget that they nominated a non-white director this year, Alejandro González Iñárritu, the first Mexican director to be nominated in the Academy's 86 Years of Film Awards. Your move, super racists. Also, this just in. Oh yes, I'm getting acknowledgement that women get as paid as much and or equally as men. They also, the ice in the polar ice caps is actually refreezing it in on itself. And obesity is totally in this year. Listen, as a white college educated male, it's easy to take all of these things in stride. To say that we're moving towards equality and these are just weird exceptions, but these aren't exceptions. These are the rules. Rules that support Duke University when it rescinded its invitation to its Muslim community to have their call to prayer in the famed Duke Chapel. The university cited security concerns, but will continue to allow its Muslim community to use the chapel's basement because, you know, security down there, Whenever we can see you, yeah, top notch. As much as I would like to think that this issue is only in the kingdom of the Rat King, it isn't. Let's not forget that the North Carolina Board of Governors is planning on cutting funding or just shutting down 34 centers and institutions across the university system. Places like the North Carolina Women's Center, the Stone Center for Black Culture and History, and the Center on Poverty, Work, and Opportunity, or pretty much every institution that doesn't serve rich white males. It's not clear where the $15 million that would be saved would go, but I have a feeling that probably doesn't involve amplifying the voices of minorities. I'm thinking Chick-fil-A and tickets to see the Dave Matthews Band. But it's not just a lack of tolerance, but the lack of recognition from the basement of Duke to the North Carolina college campuses to the Oscar ballot. It's time for some change. That's what I say. I think people should talk about that. And wait. Wow, this is just so unexpected. But I had something prepared. First off, I would really like to thank all of my white peers who neglected to give it to any other person of a different race, nationality, or gender. And I'm not really sure what I won this for, but whenever I doubt myself, I just like to look in the mirror and know I deserved it more than most people. Thank you so much. I want to thank my mom, too, and all the other people who helped me get to this this race and this gender position today. That's all, you guys. I got to go. Thank you so much, and this has been Carolina Ketchup. Bye.